Welcome. This is the Algebra 1 end of course practice test 3, question number 50. The question says, which number has the greatest value? Now, there's a few ways that you could do this. I'm going to use a TI-84 plus to convert everything to decimals. It's easier to combine them this way. You can do this method with pretty much any calculator. You can actually do it with square root charts, or if you just know them, or you can just do some division and get all the same answers. So this isn't a very difficult sort of thing to do. What I should mention is that some of these easily reduce down, like the square root of 3 I know is something around 1.7 something or other. So if you have a square root chart handy, that's you'd be very appreciative of having that there. And then this would be 49 divided by 16, or the square root of 49 divided by 16, so you end up with 7 over 4. So then you can just do the divisions and convert them all into decimals, and it'll work. I don't want to do that much work because I'm making tons of these things, so I'm just going to do the easier version because I'm lazy. So I have 1 as 1.2. And what I want to do is make a chart where I sort of, not really a chart, but I want to make some sort of line where I line up all the decimal points. That's important to me. For those of you who don't know, I hit the square root button, which is second square root, or second x squared if you have the TI-84 plus, and then get to the fraction menu, go alpha y equals, and it pops up. There's other, depending on your version, there's tons of other ways to do that. Then you get 7 over 4, and then I want to convert that into a decimal, so I hit math and go to convert decimal, and hit enter, and it tells me it's 1.75. 1.21 is already there, and the last one is, of course, my previously mentioned square root of 3 would have helped if I'd hit the actual square root button. There we go. You get 1.73. Now, I need to make comparisons of these things by place value from left to right. Which number has the greatest value? Well, the ones are all the same, so everything is good there. In the second row, my tenth place, this one would be out, as would this one. So I'm left with 1.75 and 1.73. I don't know why I wrote 5 there. So now I need to compare my hundredths place, and obviously 5 is bigger than 3. So I would say that 49, the square root of 49 over 16, gives me the greatest overall value in that one, and it's B. So if you just do turn all them into decimals and then line them up, it makes your life much easier in terms of analyzing whether they're bigger or smaller. This is great to use also if you have to order them from least to greatest or whatever. Just pay very close attention to what the question asks you to find, because it'd be very easy for me to pick A as my answer, even though it's obviously not the correct answer. If I thought, oh, they're asking for the least, I would pick A. So just be careful to answer the question they ask you. You'll get that one right, and you'll move on.